it does pay to advertise. Do you know that that day, within 30 minutes after the time the show went off, one of the listeners' wife was down here with a sack of tomatoes for me.
Oh, that's neat.
And they were wonderful.
That is neat.
Isn't that wonderful?
Great tomatoes.
Well, it's not only the great tomatoes and enjoying them, but it is kind of a testimony as to what kind of listeners we've got.
Mm-hmm.
You have
gullible.
The best.
Gullible. You call here and whine about tomatoes, and you got a whole sack.
And
full.
I got a sack.
I love America.
Yeah. Well, yesterday we were doing who ought to play roles of all the people at the show.
Mm-hmm.
And I left one out. Now, you have met this lady. This is the person who would play the role of the hat lady. Now, she was on her best behavior when you've met her.
Mm-hmm.
Lucille Ball. Now, am I wrong or what?
The hat lady with Lucille Ball.
Yeah. Lucille Ball should play the role of the hat lady.
I like it.
Yeah, I think it's perfect.
I like it.
Because she has her moments. And that reminds me so much, because I don't know how many times I have looked across the table and said, explain it to me, Lucy.
Explain it.
Well, a new season starts today.
What season is that?
Baseball. They had a break yesterday. This will start a new season.
Okay,
right?
Wonderful. I am ready. I really miss them when they're not on.
Yep.
I really do.
Oh, I do too.
Yeah. Yeah,
but it was Thursday night,
yeah.
And I really didn't care. We had a prayer meeting last night, as you recall.
Good.
Yes. So, let's have a great weekend, and we're going to have all no-hitters, yeah. The other team.
Yeah, that's what we start back now.
Yeah.
And let's get on with this.
Yeah.
Let's get this
over with.
Get it wrapped up.
Yep.
Do the job. My man, you hang right in there, and I will see you the very next time I'm in your shop.
I'm out of here like a tooth connected to a doorway.
Take care of yourself.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. Dougie Wuggy from Cleveland, Tennessee. Right back to the phones and go to Crabapple, Georgia, and talk to Milton. Good morning, Milton.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Milton Crabapple.
Hello, Sheriff. How you doing? Sounds like you're doing...
I'm doing fine, Ludlow.
Sounds like it.
Doing fine.
Good.
I disagree with you, dude. I don't think Benny's nothing like Pee Wee Herman. Ludlow?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude's trying to figure out about this Life and Times of Ludlow thing that
yeah.
you're talking about.
Casting the movie.
Yes, sir. Ludlow?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I spend lots of time out in the woods and the fields, and I see a lot of interesting things.
Yeah.
You know, especially with animals, critters.
Mm-hmm.
And they're a lot smarter than folks give them credit sometimes. I see some things that just, sometimes you just can't get over. And I seen something this morning I thought you'd be interested in.
Well, tell me about it.
Well, I was over at Old Man Eaters' pond fishing this morning.
Mm-hmm.
And I was sitting there on the stool fishing, watching all of my rods. And I heard something rustling around in the leaves. And at first I thought it was a snake. But I got to looking, it was one of them little chipmunks.
Yeah.
You know, one of them little ground squirrels.
Mm-hmm.
And he was running back and forth in the leaves right down at the edge of the water. And he was looking at something out in the water. Well, I just stood right still and sat right still where he wouldn't see me. And I got to looking, and there was a big tree stump about 8 feet out in the water. And it wasn't sticking up out of the water but a couple of inches where it broke off. But there was a big green white oak acorn laying on that tree stump.
Mm-hmm.
I reckon that chipmunk could see that thing. And he was just going back and forth and back and forth looking at it. Well, all of a sudden, that little rascal just dove in the water, Ludlow, and swam just lickety-split like a muskrat out there to that tree stump, jumped up on it and grabbed that acorn and stuffed that thing over in that one of them cheek pouches that they got.
Mm-hmm.
And come a-swimming right back with it just as pretty as you please. Well, now I was watching him, and he got about halfway back. And all of a sudden, there was a gull-derndest explosion in the water you ever saw in your life, Ludlow. There was a big-mouth bass, must have weighed 10 pounds, come through there and just engulfed him, and he was gone. Yes, sir.
Wow.
All the ripples just settled back down. It's just like nothing ever happened.
Uh-huh.
Just like there never was a chipmunk.
Uh-huh.
If that wasn't something.
What's something?
I couldn't get over it.
Yeah.
Anyhow, I sat right still, and I was pondering the whole situation, and all of a sudden I seen this shadow under the water come a-slipping in there, and it was that big bass, Ludlow. And he went right over to that tree stump, and he come up and just kind of pooched his lips out, and he spit another acorn up on that tree stump. Yes, sir. Girl, darndest thing I ever seen in my life.
May have been an acorn to you, but it was bait to him.
It must have been. That wasn't something.
That's quite a story.
You see some strange things.
Life in the outdoors, yes.
Yes, sir. But anyhow, I just thought I'd pass that along to you.
Well, that's very interesting. I wish you had a camera. I've never seen a bass pooch his lips out.
Well, I'm going to try to catch me some of them chipmunks for bait.
There you go.
Yes, sir.
Don't tell them how big a bass you can catch.
Stop by if you get a chance. We'll go fishing, Ludlow.
I'm going to do that. I want you to take me so I can see you catch some snapping turtles. That's what I want to do.
You know, I'm going to have a video coming out soon. We're working on it right now, and it should be out in about a month, Ludlow.
Oh, good.
And you're going to get one of the very first copies of it.
Well, that's good. And
they ain't going to charge you but half price for it.
Plus postage and handling.
Yes, sir.
Well, that's fair.
And it's called Grappling.
Okay.
Well, it's got a whole adventure of turtle grappling on there, plus lots of other fun stories and all kinds of things.
I cannot wait, and that'll be out in about a month.
Yes, sir, and I'm going to deliver you one up by hand,
all
too.
All right,
Ludlow.
All right. I'm looking forward to it.
If you get a chance, let Benny borrow it,
and
too.
And these will be available to the public?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I'll keep you posted on it, Ludlow.
Do that now. I want to know the progress of that.
Well, I'll keep you posted.
All right, I'll talk to you.
Much obliged.
I'll see you later.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. Sheriff Milton Crabapple. Denny, do you believe that story about the chipmunk? That's what I call a fish story. More conversation right after this. Hop on Seeker's Ludlow Porch with a...
Up this morning before the sun. Fixed me some coffee and a honey bun. Jumped in the pickup. Gave her the gas, I'm going out to catch a 5-pound bass.
1-800-572-8255, Rome, Georgia, and Jim on the radio. Hello, sir, Jim.
Good morning, Cousin Ludlow.
Good morning to you.
Oh, what an enjoyable morning it has been.
Good.
With the sheriff and Ron and getting to hear that, I don't mind hanging on as long as Tom Dooley, you know? Anyway, something extra should be in Denny's pay envelope this coming payday.
Okay, because of that wonderful show yesterday?
Well, a guy who can work without supervision like that, that's really I got to get in my point. And I'm just about over having my ego bruised Friday.
Oh, what happened to your ego?
Well, there's been a long dry spell about original humor.
Yeah.
And I thought that I had come up with some original satire, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I says, the reaction about the first guy that ate chicken.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't even wait 5 seconds. You said, tastes like frog's leg.
I apologize. That
no,
was,
no, no.
That
no.
was a bad thing to do.
No, I was no better than to tell something like that to a quick study like yourself.
That was out of my mouth before I knew it.
I would like to think that was kind of original, though. I'd never heard it before.
No, I'd never heard it.
Of course, my answer to that was, tastes like rattlesnake.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with regard to Ron's quarter horse he's talking about, you know, Ronnie Wood, he talked about his quarter horse.
Quarter horse?
Yeah, he said something about having a quarter horse.
I must have missed that.
Well, anyway, you know how you can tell when he's coming on his quarter horse?
Oh, yeah, no, a hobby horse, he said.
Hobby horse.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
But go ahead. Go with the quarter horse line.
Okay. Might as well. Well, you know those short, choppy little hoof feet.
Yeah. I just got a visual. I'm sorry.
Okay. That's all right. That's what I'm here for. And, you know, often people call up and compliment you on having a clean show.
Yeah.
And I want to reiterate, you know how hard it is to say reiterate when you've been drinking?
It is tough.
But it is too bad sometimes that you can't tell stories like the guy down at the train station that's been hired to say free bus to the Hotel Astor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, can't tell those, can you?
No.
Or the one in the middle is Willie Nelson. Can't tell that one either.
No. No. Well, you know, sometimes it does get kind of frustrating.
Well, we have to keep a clean tongue in our head.
That's right, we do. Well, I'm off to Alabama in the morning to a model airplane meet that only people over 50 are invited to.
All right.
So that ought to be a horrible bunch of crashes.
Do they have a name for this meet?
No, it's just there's no competition and no wagering. And, of course, no drinking.
It sounded like fun.
Yeah, and there'd be catfish and hush puppies and everything after all the aircraft were torn up. But anyway, wish me luck. I am going with a windbag.
I wish you luck.
I'm going with a windbag now. That's not my driver, Big Red. That's the tiny name of the flying machine I'm taking.
Oh, okay, good.
So you have a good weekend.
I win first prize.
Well, okay. Be careful now.
I'll talk to you, buddy.
All right, buddy.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Jasper Jeep Gang, no matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Ludlow and Denny, it is the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Now, this is Friday, and somebody mentioned the topic a few minutes ago. Every Friday, we leave this wide open for you to call in and get caught up on everything been going on in your life. We realize fully that during the week, you're busy running around chasing the dollar, and you just don't have time to call in like you would like to. Something gets said you want to comment on, and you can't get in. Friday is the day, and here is the place. It's 1-800-572-8255, 1-800-572-TALK. And as you can tell by that 800 prefix, it is a toll-free call. Sunday, September the 7th, going to have a gathering, gang. Panthers versus... Go to Rome, Georgia, and talk to the old disc jockey. Hello, big boy. Old disc jockey had to leave us. Bless his heart. 1-800-572-8255. Dynamite is on board. Hello, young lady.
Well, good morning, Ludlow.
How's your sweet self?
Well, my sweet self, I can't do any better.
Good.
I mean, I am just doing fantastic. It's Friday, and I mean, everything's right.
Yeah, that's perfect.
I got to tell you what happened. You know, I called you a week or so ago about a problem I had with my refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
Got it fixed.
Oh, good.
And guess what it was?
What was it?
The filter went out on it. The filter had gotten too full. It was doing what it was supposed to do. It went out, caused a leak, but it was not the major part that we thought it was.
So it's fixed for good and all.
I think so, until we need another filter. But
well, good.
I mean, excuse me, I get to do this every time I call you. The thing only costs like $6. I mean, you can't beat that.
Nope.
And I had a good friend that came in, knew how to do it, and they fixed it, and I'm set.
No, that's wonderful.
Got a movie title for your movie.
All right.
I'm going to take it for what it's worth. Luddy Land.
Okay.
I mean, that's about the best I can do. Happy birthday to the man with his hand up.
All right. He's having a good one. He's a little depressed, but not much.
Well, now, you can't be depressed. I mean, you know, life begins at 50.
Yeah,
I mean, it did for me.
I hope it does for him, too.
Well, let me tell you what one of the worst performances I saw, and I'm going to make some people mad when I tell you this, but it was Elvis. I went to see him at the Macon Coliseum. It must have been the next to the last performance that he made.
Mm-hmm.
And well, it wasn't that he was all that bad, but we had to sit in the very top of that place, and there were so many cameras going off and so much smoke, we didn't enjoy it at all,
no matter what kind of job he would have done. But I'll say this.
What's that?
I saw him in Las Vegas at the Hilton, where he was his return to Las Vegas after so many years.
Yeah.
And there were no cameras going off and no smoke where we were, and I still didn't enjoy it.
Well, Oh, well, I just wanted to be able to say that I had been near where he was.
Well, that's important. We're talking about an American icon there. By any yardstick you want to use, he was as beloved entertainer as it ever lived.
Yeah, I liked him, but I wasn't all that hung up on him.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I saw that he was just a man like anybody else.
Mm-hmm.
And some good performances I saw was Charlie Pride and Engelbert Humperdinck.
I bet both of those were great.
Yeah, they really were.
Yeah.
That's been a long time ago, but I can't even remember now where I saw them. I know it was up here because I'd already moved up in this area when I saw them.
Mm-hmm.
But they were very good. I think it had been in the 70s.
Yeah.
But one of the things my dad used to say that was funny, he used to make fun of, he would to distinguish between a heavy-set lady and a slender lady. The heavy-set one was a bag. And back, you remember back when people used to wear the sack dress?
Mm-hmm.
There goes a bag in a sack.
That's funny.
And the lady, like I said, the slender one was a bat. So, and then my mama used to say whenever she was talking about somebody was ugly, she said, they're as ugly as homemade sin.
Yeah, yeah.
But homemade sin used to tickle me.
Well, that's very descriptive if you stop and think about it.
Very.
Yeah. And that came from the era, where a lot of things were homemade and not very well made. And wearing ugly dress, it was homemade. And
there you go.
Homemade sin, very ugly, very descriptive.
Yeah, they were funny. They said some funny things.
Love it.
I just wish they were still around, but they're not.
Oh, yeah, I know. Time marches on, unfortunately.
Yeah, and we have to march on with it, don't we?
Amen. You take
well,
care of
I hope you have a super weekend.
I'm looking forward to it. You do the same.
All right, thanks.
Talk to you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Blue Willow Inn Gang, gracious hospitality and superb Southern food. Let's talk to the man of the hour, the man of every hour, my close personal friend and benefactor, Choo Choo Man from Dallas.
Hello, Ludlow.
What do you say, big guy?
I ain't talking much. And that's a bad thing to do when you get on radio.
Yeah, that's a killer. That's a killer.
Did you want a two-door or a four-door? And you can't tell that one on radio either. Oh, do you think there's a chance of us maybe hearing Elvis record or two this weekend?
Oh, I think so.
Yeah,
I think on television, all channels, and on radios, all stations.
We stand a pretty good chance of hearing some Elvis.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think so, too. Well, now, today's date is a real important date, and if you've mentioned it, I missed it. But do you know what it is?
No, I don't.
BJ Day.
Wow. And you know, I didn't see a word in the paper. Today is BJ Day?
Today is BJ Day. Surrender Japan.
Yeah, I cannot imagine why that didn't make the papers at all. Sometimes they try to hold that down because they're so afraid of offending the Japanese, they don't want to...
They're afraid it'll interfere with the sale of cars.
Well, yeah, and so they just kind of going to play like that didn't happen.
Do you realize if that hadn't have happened, that there wouldn't be any Toyotas around over here and all these other little foreign cars, they wouldn't be here.
That's a point.
Yeah,
you're probably right.
But I hadn't heard you mention
no,
it.
No, I hadn't.
Today is the day.
Well, you
52 years ago.
You would have thought that had been all over the papers, wouldn't you?
Yeah, you would. Yeah.
Well,
sometimes
try not to notice.
I bet all them old boys in World War II remember.
Oh, yeah, as well they should. Got to get out of here, Chew.
All right, have a good one.
All right, I'm glad you're there, and stay in touch.
I'll do it.
Bye-bye, baby.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. More right after this.
¿Y qué le hacemos a Babalú? Dame 17 velas.
All right, Desi Arnaz. And the song he made famous. 1-800-572-8255. As we talk to Marcia on the radio. Hello, Miss Marcia.
Hello, Mr. Port.
How you doing, my friend?
I'm good. I'm desperately looking for a copy of your cookbook for a friend who's really sick, and he could sure use a laugh about now. And I've exhausted every possibility that I know of. I'm hoping you've got a dusty copy in the corner of your garage.
No, I sure don't. That book is very, very hard to find, and it may be reprinted one of these days, but not in time to do your friend any good. I've got, you know, other books that are available, but a lot of them are just, you know, they're just sold well and so well you can't find them.
Well, I'm so glad for you.
Well, thank you.
They need to do another printing.
I hope they will, but drop me a note if you want to, and I'll send you a list of the ones that are available and that I have.
All right, I appreciate it.
All right, my friend.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for your interest.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, the old DJ in Rome is back. Hello there.
I was just sitting there, and all of a sudden, I just heard a beep, and I was gone.
You were gone.
I was. I just wasn't there no more.
Well, we're glad you're back.
Well, I'm glad to be back. I always hear a story, I think, about you, and I say, well, I'm going to have to call Ludlow, tell him his story. Ludlow, there was a couple, man and woman, that were married, and they were very frugal. To tell you the truth, they were cheap.
Uh-huh.
And they went to a carnival, and this guy had an old biplane there that he was taking people up for $5 a piece and showing them the town. And they went over, and he said, Mr. Pilot said, if I just let my wife sit in my lap, would you take us up to $5? He said, no, it's $5 a piece. He said, but I'll tell you what I'll do. He said, I'll take you up. If you don't say anything, I'll give you the $10 back when we land on the ground. The guy said, that's fine. So they went up. He went straight up, Ludlow, came straight down, almost hit the ground, did a barrel loop. He did everything in the world he could do. And he landed, he turned around to the guy, and he said, well, I tell you one thing, you didn't say anything. Here's your $10. The guy said, I almost did when my wife fell out.
A temptation.
So you can... Let me tell you one other thing. 52 years ago today, I was in Columbus, Georgia, standing on the main street over there with a microphone, interviewing the boys from Fort Benning.
Oh.
And all of the others who were rejoicing because that war was over.
Yeah.
And that was a great day. I tell you what.
It was a day we had looked forward to for a long time.
That's a mess. That's an amen, brother. But I tell you, it's amazing that they don't remember it as much as I think they should.
Well, you're exactly right. And I don't know whether that... I just looked at the front page of USA Today to see if I could see a little blurb or something, and I don't see anything in there.
Yeah. But tell you the truth, I forgot about it.
I did, too.
You know. I didn't remember it, but I remember that day because we stayed on the air over there about 4 hours, just standing there letting people come up, people falling on their knees. I tell you, it was a sight.
It was something.
My friend, you got a good program, and I'm amazed at the amount of people who listen to it, because somebody said, well, I heard you on Ludlow Ports the other day. I said, well, it's always a pleasure to be with him because he's a nice man.
You're a great American.
Thank you, buddy.
Good to talk to
See you.
You. Aubrey in Lowndes County, another great American.
Thank you, Ludlow.
Back-to-back great Americans, Aubrey.
Yeah, there you go. I thank the world of you, Ludlow.
Bless you.
I couldn't let the weekend come up without saying hello.
All right.
What do you plan on doing this weekend?
As little as possible.
There you go. I want to tell you a story right quick, and then I'm going to let you get on.
All right.
When I was in 10th grade, about 1977, 78, somewhere in there,
uh-huh.
I was a shy little old weeby little boy. everybody used to take my lunch and steal it and squish it and sometimes hand it back to me squished and sometimes not give it back to me, but when they handed it back to me, it was never fit to eat.
Yeah.
Well, my future sister-in-law, the only in-law that I care anything about anyway, she came into class one day, new to teacher. She said, excuse my interruption, but I got some business to attend to. So she went to my desk. There's two guys who used to squish my lunch in this class. I ain't going to give her a name because I didn't ask her permission to tell the story. But something I'll always remember.
Now, how old was she?
She's just a year older than I am.
Okay, so you were in the 10th grade and she was in the 11th.
In 11th, right.
Okay.
And She come over my desk and she says, Aubrey, who are the two guys who keep stealing your lunch and squish it? And I was kind of afraid to say, because I was afraid that when she left, they'd going to beat the car out of me.
Might be reprisals, yeah.
I kind of glanced over at them and pointed to them. There they are. And she said, okay, just wait here. She went over there to their desk and she said, you see that little fellow over there? He tells me that you've been squishing his lunch, and he's my future brother-in-law. And she said, and you know who I am, and you know what I'll do, and if I ever hear from that little boy that you took his lunch again, well, it's going to be in you and me. And you know, they didn't ever mess with me again.
That was a young lady who believed in taking the bull by the horns.
Exactly. And you know, she had a birthday this past weekend, and I bought her a nice little card and told her how much I appreciate her. And I told her that I'd always remember that she stood up for me when I was in high school.
What a wonderful story. And she wound up your sister-in-law, and I bet you still love her.
Yeah, and that's the only in-law that I care about.
You don't like the rest of them?
No, they ain't none worth a flip. You have a good weekend, Ludlow.
Aubrey, great story, buddy. I appreciate it.
Talk to you later.
Take care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255, Bamberg, South Carolina, and cash. What do you say, cash? You just told yourself a great story, did you?
No, man.
Yeah.
I got to tell you this.
All right.
This is a bad day for me.
Bad day for you.
I still remember the war, Lolo.
Uh-huh.
And I got shell shot. What happened was it was a helicopter.
Uh-huh.
There were three of us in it. We were flying low. We had orders to go to the Red Cross and come right back. When we got there, the lieutenant said, jump, Cash, jump. I went to the door, and I looked down. I got scared, you know. I started screaming, man. I ran back in the plane. I pulled all the buttons I could grab in the helicopter. I don't know what happened to me. It turned upside down, you know. All three of us fell out. The plane went back to New York upside down. When they threw me out, they said I was a disaster.
Uh-huh.
Have a nice weekend, my lord.
Take care. Denny, am I the only one that didn't understand any of that? 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. I don't know where the summer's gone, but I do know that it won't be long before those school bells start ringing.
Yeah, baby.
Let's talk to our beloved Morning Glory. Hello, young lady.
How in the world are you?
I am so good.
I know you are, but you weren't there yesterday. And yesterday was my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday, a little late.
Thank you to you. But I tell you what, I'm going to really blow some of these non-historians out of the water.
All right.
Because the reason y'all aren't finding anything out about VJ Day today is because it was yesterday.
Because
it was on my birthday, and I remember that.
Was there anything in the paper yesterday?
I don't know. I didn't pay any attention. Because, you know, one of the things that bothers me, you know, being a good old teacher and this sort of thing,
uh-huh.
is that too many people are trying to change history.
Uh-huh.
And that really, I mean, it scares me, because I've seen things in textbooks that just aren't so. I mean, there are a lot of things that you can't really guess dead on.
Yeah.
But some things that are just dead on, they're kind of either fudging on it or making light of it or changing it to suit their purposes.
Mm-hmm.
And that's getting scary.
That is. That's awful. That's a terrible thing to do.
And it's happening more and more.
Yeah.
The only thing I want them to fudge on is my age.
That's right. They can lie all they want to about it.
Yeah, they can really put a big fudge across the page on that. But I tell you, it was wonderful to have a birthday following such august people as Choo Choo and Bulldog Betty.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And don't forget today, the guy with his hand up.
Oh, yeah. See all these good Leos that are born and just strut around here like we're supposed to. The king of the roost, as it were.
Exactly.
All right, I know one other thing I want you to do.
Okay.
I want you to get Milton and corner him and say, Milton, you got to take me to lunch. And there's a great place right across the street from the jail where he needs to take you. It really is. It's an old, old house that they were going to use by the fire department as a demonstration we're burning this sucker down thing.
Yeah, I've been there.
Have you?
Yeah.
Don't you think that's good?
I haven't been there in a while, but very good food, yeah.
Well, that's where my gang took me yesterday for lunch.
Oh, good.
And we had that chocolate cake of theirs, and I'm telling you, I got on the scales this morning and it said one at a time, please. I mean to tell you, it was worth every bite of it.
I know the feeling. A little conscience, but that's all, right?
I mean,
just a little.
My conscience was a lot smaller than what I packed away.
Oh, that's good.
But it was great. But do go back again, because it's even better.
Well, I will. It's just living in the mountains is a little tougher to get out than it used to be, but I will.
I know. But old Milton, tell him it's his time to pay.
All right. All right. I love it.
You have a super weekend.
Okay, you do the same.
Tell all the people who think it's on the 15th to go back and search their history books. I will tell you one thing, though. There is a controversy about when the war legally was over.
Yeah.
And that's because of the same thing that I was mentioning about New Zealand being the first one to see the millennium and all this sort of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because the international dateline, you know, the papers were signed in the Pacific Ocean. And
yeah.
So consequently, it was one day in our country when the papers were signed and another day out there where they were actually signed.
Okay.
And which always messes me up. You know, don't mess with my mind.
Me too, no.
And
I don't want to reset my watch anymore, let alone my calendar.
You know, I don't even do that. When I go on one of my little jaunts, it keeps Atlanta time. I said, I want to know where my people are.
There you go.
You have a great weekend.
Okay, good to talk to you.
Good to talk to you, too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hey, visit Colonel Poole's Barbecue in East LJ, Georgia, and see the world-famous Pig Hill of Fame. Spartanburg and my buddy Doc on the radio. Hello, Doctor.
Good morning, Luddy Buddy.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How you doing?
Great.
Getting ready for a good weekend?
I hope so, yeah.
You and me both. I want to ask you a question, and I've got something to tell you. You know, a couple of 3 weeks ago, I called and asked you if you could find me a source for some pictures or a book or whatever about the Rolling Stores.
Yeah.
Has anybody ever called? I haven't had the chance to listen.
No. What led to an awful lot of conversation about the Rolling Stores, and I asked most of them about books, and if there's ever been one, I can't imagine there not being, but if there's ever been one, I haven't been able to find anything out.
Okay. I got wind of a press up in Connecticut that puts out these kind of books, and I got their 1-800 number, and I called them the other day to send their catalog, so I'll let you know if I find anything.
Please let me know.
Okay. Now, I told you last weekend I was going to the Edsel show here in Spartanburg.
Yeah.
International Edsel Club.
Yeah.
I want to tell you about a couple of those boogers I saw.
All right.
One of them, you remember the Ford Ranchero?
Yeah.
Pickup truck Ford Ranchero?
Mm-hmm.
Well, a guy had a 59 Ford Ranchero. He took the grill out of the thing and the hood off the thing. And he put the hood of a 59, he didn't have to rebore any holes whatsoever. He put the hood of a 59 Edsel on it and the grill of a 59 Edsel, the headlights, all the trim on the side, the tail lights and all that on the tailgate of the Ranchero, and he calls it an Edchero.
Oh, well, that's funny.
How about that?
That's funny. And the old world's only Edsel pickup.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
I love it.
And another man got so much money that he had a Lincoln Town Car.
Mm-hmm.
You know how fancy they are.
Oh, yeah.
And plush and all. Well, he took the body off of the Lincoln Town Car and put the body of a 59 Edsel on that booger. Spent $50,000 doing this because he didn't even have the door handles on it anymore. He had it sanded and buffed and all that kind of thing. It's just as slick as a button on the outside, everywhere you look.
Yeah.
But it is the body of an Edsel on the frame and the motor and the interior of a Lincoln Town Car, and he spent $50,000 doing that thing.
Pretty creative.
I'm telling you.
Pretty creative.
And you asked me last week if they had gone up much in value.
Mm-hmm.
I saw two side by side. They weren't the same color, but they were the same. They were 58 Edsel convertibles with a Continental kit.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them. And one of them was for sale, one of them wasn't. The one that wasn't for sale, I asked the man, I said, if it was for sale, what would you want for it? He said, $50,000. The man that had one for sale, just exactly like it, different color, he wanted $25,000 for his. But I'm just telling you, if it's for sale, it's cheaper than if it's not for sale. And still, $25,000 is still too steep for me.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty high.
I'm telling you what.
That's pretty high.
There were some sharp cars there. About 100, 115 of them.
I know you had a time.
Absolutely did.
All right, bud. You take care. I'll talk to you soon.
Talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
More conversation right after I tell you. Thought I'd go forget Denny did you? See? Denny, ye of little faith. Denny was already opening the intercom button. Want to tell you about my buddy. Noonan, Georgia, and Al on the radio. Hello, Big Al.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, thank you.
Good.
Wonderfully refreshing out in the country after these wonderful rains.
Oh, yeah, good. Yeah, that's a little cleansing going on.
Oh, breath of life.
Mm-hmm.
Ludlow, I was born in the mid-1930s, and I just feel that folks that were born back then have a greater appreciation for the great American way. And that is that hard work will get you what you want. In 1940, my dad experienced the great American dream. He went from a tenant farmer to getting his own farm and home.
Mm-hmm.
And each one of the children had a job. And I mean, we worked hard, and each one worked hard to try and help pay for that farm. And he purchased that thing. You know, back then, there was millions of farms probably all across America.
Sure.
And you could purchase those farms for about 2% interest, about 30-year note. And it took about 12 years, and through hard work, we had that thing paid for. I mean, raising cotton and corn and milking cows and all of the hard work. And one of the jobs I remember early that I did, and I think I was about 6 years old, and my dad had this big cornfield down on the river bottom. And my job was to drop a grain of corn in between every hill at which there wasn't a good stand. And my dad believed in having a good stand of corn. And boy, we would work hard, and we would sweat, and we would get thirsty, and we just went right over to the river, and my dad would pull the turtle shell hat off his head and reach down in that water and rinse it out a couple of times, and we would just drink until we satisfied our thirst.
I think your first observation was, and here's something people don't realize, that the American dream is first and foremost based on hard work. I got to get out of here, old friend. You take care of yourself.
Appreciate it.
Talk to you.
Thank you.
Taylor Construction Company gang, you call them and never ever paint again. We'll be right back with you first thing Monday morning. Have a great weekend, and you do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Good morning. You're with WBIC, Northeast Georgia's Gospel Connection. We've got NBC News coming up at 12 o'clock. Lewis will be in with you. It's 83 degrees on this Friday. Happy Friday. I'll be checking out of here. So news is next, and we'll be back with more of your favorite gospel music right after the lunchtime hour. So stay with us. WBIC, Royston, Georgia. You're with WBIC 810 AM, Royston, Georgia.
NBC Radio News. The pickets are on station. The negotiators are...